In December 2020, the COVID-19 vaccine developed by Moderna received its emergency use authorization from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration, making the vaccine officially available to the public. Here are the reported results and side effects of the Moderna vaccine explained. A significant issue the FDA considered prior to issuing its emergency use authorization for the Moderna vaccine for COVID-19 is the vaccine's effectiveness. In a press release announcing the EUA of the Moderna vaccine, the FDA pointed out that some of the data on which it had relied in granting the EUA included a study involving 28,207 people in the US who received the vaccine in a randomized, placebo-controlled study. Of the 14,134 people who received the vaccine for the study, only 11 contracted COVID-19, with only one case identified, but not confirmed as potentially being severe. Of the 14,073 people who got the placebo, 185 contracted COVID-19, and 30 cases were severe. In other words, the Moderna vaccine for COVID-19 appears to be 94.1% effective in those who received it under the study. In addition, it appears that the Moderna vaccine may have been at least somewhat effective at preventing severe COVID-19 infections in study participants. What is still not known is how long the vaccine-conferred immunity will last, or whether it is still possible to catch and then spread the virus asymptomatically after you've had both doses. The Moderna COVID-19 vaccine is administered as a series of two injections into the upper arm muscle, spaced 1 month apart, according to the FDA's Moderna vaccine EUA fact sheet. Included in the safety-related data that the FDA used in granting Moderna's emergency use authorization for its vaccine, a randomized, placebo-controlled study was conducted in which 30,351 U.S. volunteers were administered either the vaccine or a saline placebo. Researchers followed up with all the volunteers for a median time of at least 2 months after the second dose had been administered, taking note of all relevant information, including confirmed COVID-19 diagnoses and adverse effects. What the researchers found was that in the group of 15,185 people who received the vaccine, more people experienced side effects after the second dose than after the first dose. In addition, Moderna has made a point of disclosing that more adverse reactions, potentially even serious ones, may reveal themselves as more and more people receive the vaccine. One of the most common side effects of the Moderna vaccine is temporary soreness at the injection site, which may also include localized redness and/or swelling. As many as 92% of people who got Moderna's COVID-19 vaccine report pain at the injection site, lasting 2 to 3 days on average. Another 14.7% reported swelling accompanying the physical discomfort, and another 10% reported redness at the injection site. This side effect can present up to 10 days after you've received your shot, explained Dr. Thomas Carey to Illinois' WIFR newsroom.
It potentially is related to maybe a preservative that's in the vaccine, and that's maybe what is causing this reaction.
Some people refer to this phenomenon as Moderna arm because it occurs more frequently with the Moderna vaccine than the other two, as confirmed to San Francisco's ABC 7 News by Dr. Rebecca Saff. Dr. Saff is one of the co-authors of a study published in the New England Journal of Medicine attempting to get to the bottom of this phenomenon. Although the study shed little light on why it happens, it did demonstrate that it's still safe to proceed with a second shot of the vaccine even if the reaction occurs.
For most people, it was much less with their second dose.
The Moderna vaccine against COVID-19 has been known to cause a cluster of flu-like side effects. These include fatigue, reported by 70% of recipients, headache, reported by 64.7%, muscle pain, reported by 61.5%, chills, reported by 45.4%, and fever, reported by 15.5%. However, these side effects are actually a sign that the vaccine is doing what it's supposed to do, which is to train your immune system to start developing antibodies. According to Dr. Soba Swaminathan, clinical research site leader for the Rutgers University Moderna trial, on average, the flu-like side effects last no longer than 3 days. While you might be tempted to take an over-the-counter pain relief medication in the hopes of nipping these side effects in the bud, you'd be wise to wait until after you have symptoms, according to Dr. Adam Brady, chair of the Samaritan Coronavirus Task Force. Speaking at a seminar on coronavirus vaccines in early 2021, Dr. Brady said, certain pain relievers may inhibit the vaccine from doing its job. Anti-inflammatory medications could inhibit the immune response, resulting in potentially fewer antibodies. Since headaches are a side effect reportedly experienced by 64.7% of those who have received the Moderna vaccine against COVID-19, it's understandable that people prone to experiencing migraines might have their concerns. However, the American Migraine Foundation put that risk into perspective with a statement, saying, "The side effects of the vaccine are usually mild, short-lived, and are the body's normal and expected response to the vaccine. COVID-19 infections can be severe and life-threatening, affecting you, your family, and friends." For those at risk for migraine headaches, the AMF suggests having a discussion in advance with a healthcare provider in order to have a treatment plan in place in the case that a migraine response occurs. It also pointed out that there's no evidence that a person experiencing migraines after taking the vaccine shouldn't also take migraine treatment medications in response to it, although the combination has not yet been clinically studied. However, many suspect that taking over-the-counter pain relievers within the 24 hours before and after receiving the Moderna vaccine may inhibit the vaccine's effectiveness by decreasing the immune response to the vaccine. Clinical trials have shown that all three of the vaccines against COVID-19 in use right now, as a result of the FDA's emergency use authorization, can have some kind of effect on the gastrointestinal system. Specifically, all three have been associated to some degree with nausea. However, gastrointestinal side effects may be somewhat more prevalent with the Moderna vaccine and may include vomiting, which does not appear to be a common side effect of the Pfizer or Johnson & Johnson vaccines, according to a side-by-side vaccine analysis by The Guardian. Per the Moderna vaccine fact sheet, 23% of those who have received the vaccine reported some degree of nausea and/or vomiting, with 9.4% experiencing it after the first dose and 21.4% after the second. However, gastrointestinal side effects, like the other side effects associated with the Moderna vaccine against COVID-19, tend to resolve within an average of 2 to 3 days after onset. This was confirmed by The Guardian's analysis, which found side effects cleared up, on average, within 3 days. Another side effect associated with the Moderna vaccine against COVID-19 is joint pain. According to the Moderna vaccine fact sheet, 46.4% of those who've received the vaccine reported that they've experienced arthralgia, also known as joint pain. Reportedly, 16.6% of vaccine recipients experienced joint pain after the first dose, and 45.2% experienced it after the second, according to the Guardian side-by-side analysis of the three vaccines that have been given FDA emergency use authorization as of March 18, 2021. While the prospect of possibly experiencing new or worsened joint pain after receiving the Moderna vaccine may be unsettling for anyone, it may be especially concerning for people already dealing with a diagnosis of arthritis. The Arthritis Foundation addressed such concerns in an article sharing its insights into what the Moderna vaccine may mean for people who have been dealing with arthritis. What the Arthritis Foundation concluded is that the Moderna vaccine can be taken by people with arthritis, including those whose arthritis is of an autoimmune nature. The foundation advised, "We encourage our constituents and their families to follow the recommendations of Dr. Anthony Fauci and get the vaccine when it's available in their state." According to the Moderna vaccine EUA fact sheet, some Moderna vaccine recipients reported tenderness or swelling of their lymph nodes in response to the shots. This swelling is also known as lymph adenopathy. Since adenopathy can be associated with cancer, this side effect of the Moderna vaccine can prove disconcerting to some. Most instances of vaccine-related adenopathy occur in the armpit that is adjacent to the injection site. However, in the 2021 case study referenced above, an otherwise healthy 37-year-old woman presented with a palpable node above the left side of her clavicle bone 5 days after receiving her first dose of the Moderna vaccine in her left arm. Cases of anaphylaxis following administration of the Moderna vaccine against COVID-19 have been reported since the vaccine was first granted emergency use authorization. According to a February 2021 article published in the Journal of the American Medical Association, the article explains that anaphylaxis is a life-threatening allergic reaction that can occur after vaccination, with onset typically within minutes to hours.
When you get these severe allergies, They occur within 15 minutes usually.
If you were to have an anaphylactic reaction to your Moderna vaccine, the symptoms, including rash, swelling, nausea, and difficulty breathing, are severe, and you would likely begin experiencing them within 6 minutes, which has been the median time to onset observed thus far. The good news is that as of February 2021, anaphylaxis had been reported in just 2.5 cases per million doses of the Moderna vaccine. The more sobering news is that most Moderna vaccine-related anaphylaxis cases were reported in people who had no prior history of anaphylactic reactions. However, all reported cases responded to treatment, and no deaths from anaphylaxis after vaccination with either product were reported. Although it's important to go into your Moderna vaccine appointment understanding the more common side effects, it's worth noting that each individual's response will be unique to that person. That said, women, as a group, tend to experience more side effects, according to a February 19th, 2021 report by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. According to an assessment by Healthline, 79% of side effects reported came from women, although only 61% of the vaccines were given to women. It's not clear why women have reported more side effects in response to the Moderna vaccine. Some experts believe that women, and particularly women who are not yet in menopause, generally have a stronger response to vaccines because they have more estrogen, which contributes to their bodies activating an immune response. In addition, older adults are reportedly less likely to experience any side effects at all, which is fortunate since older adults are considered to be the highest priority for receiving the vaccine, since, according to the CDC, the risk of severe illness from COVID-19 increases with age. Although the FDA has stated that the data shows that the benefits outweigh the risks associated with the Moderna vaccine against COVID-19, what is not yet known is the extent to which protection is afforded by the Moderna vaccine against some aspects of the virus itself. For example, it has not yet been determined how long the Moderna vaccine will continue to provide protection against COVID-19. It has also not yet been determined whether the vaccine effectively prevents transmission of the virus. The latter point is critical from a public health standpoint because it has been estimated that as many as 30% of people who test positive for the virus exhibit no symptoms. The possibility remains that one who has received the Moderna vaccine and is subsequently exposed to SARS-CoV-2 may still be capable of shedding viral particles even as their immune system successfully fights to keep COVID-19 at bay. A booster shot is defined as an additional dose of a vaccine needed periodically to boost the immune system with regard to a particular disease for which one has already been immunized, according to MedicineNet, which gave tetanus as an example of a disease for which continuing immunity requires an additional shot every 10 years. Although the World Health Organization has stated that there is currently no evidence on the need for a booster dose or booster doses of the vaccine after the current two-dose vaccine series is complete, it also has stated that the need for and timing of booster doses will be evaluated as further data accumulate. In fact, Moderna has announced it is in the process of studying the effects of adding a third dose to its regimen, according to NBC News. It remains to be seen whether a third dose or a booster shot would create a new set of side effects or worsen the sort of side effects experienced with the first two Moderna vaccine doses. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Health Digest videos about the latest medical developments are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.